Well, thank you guys for tuning in to Chicago Prayer and Hope, where we pray for you all because we believe in the power of prayer, be the praying of the true and the living God of the universe, who hear the prayers and who answer them all in His imperfect timing, because His timing is perfect and His timing will always be perfect. Amen. Amen. And also, we share the good news of Jesus Christ right out of this true and active living Word of God, which brings the free gift of salvation to you all if you believe by faith alone, and if you repent of your sins, and if you do all that, it offers the best gift of all which you can ever receive, which is eternal life with Jesus Christ forever in His presence when you die. Friends, praise God for the free gift of salvation. Praise God for eternal life. You believe that God is good? I believe that He's good as well. And I believe that He's alive as well. Today, friends, we got a good topic. We're going to be talking about how God formed everything. Do you believe that God has formed everything and created everything? I believe it. We're going to be in Psalm 90, verse 2. I think this is a great passage to get us centered on. I think this is just a great passage just to remind us of what we celebrated yesterday on July 4th, which is our freedom, the freedom that we have in this country, how God has formed everything. So we're going to be in Psalm 90, verse 2. So if you have your Bibles, I encourage you to go grab them, flip along to that passage with us, or turn on your Bibles and flip through as well. And as you flip into that passage, I will open this up in a brief word of prayer, and we'll begin. Let's pray. Father God, thank you for who you are. Thank you for your word. God, would you speak to us now by your word? Teach us what we need to be taught. We want to learn more about you and become more like you, God, and less like ourselves. We love you. Help us love you more. Amen. You guys ready? Alright, Psalm 90 verse 2 says this: Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever you had formed the earth and the world, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. Come on. Come on, friends. What does this mean? Can we reread this one more time? And as we reread this a second time, can we meditate on this passage and ask God that He would speak to us about what this means to us? You guys ready? All right. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever you had formed the earth and the world, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. What does this mean, friends? And how does this set up? It says, before the mountains were brought forth. How many of you have seen the mountains? Okay. Or ever you had formed the earth. Do you believe that you, how many of you live in the earth? I know I do. If you're a creature, if you're a human being, you live in the earth. Or ever you had formed the earth and the world, from everlasting, come on, this is the hope, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. Friends, we don't need this earth. We don't need this world. We don't need this earth. We don't need this world. Because God is God, period. Because God is who He is. God created everything. And everything exists because of Him. But God is God. What's my hope for you today? What's my encouragement for you today? My simple encouragement, my simple hope for you today is this. Is that no matter what you go through in life, whether it's really great, whether it's really bad, whether it's really hard, no matter what you go through in life, that you would remember God is God, and period. And that does not change. Circumstances can't change it. God is God, period. Amen. I hope this touches you today. Friends, we serve a good God who is worthy, who wants to meet your needs. Your needs that you're going through. Your financial needs. Your relationship needs. God is God, period. He wants a relationship with you. I pray that you would run a relationship with Him. And we're going to give you that chance to accept Him today for the first time. But come back to Him. We do this at the end of every video, because we believe in the God power of salvation. We believe that you can be saved. And that God can change your life. God has changed our lives. That we want Him to change your life as well. We believe that He can't serve you. You just say a simple prayer of faith. And it sounds from your own heart. Please repeat these words after me. So if you want to come back to God, or come to God for the first time, this is your time to. Please repeat these words after me. Father God, I confess I'm a sinner. I confess my need for you. Lord, I cannot do this life without you, Lord. You're the only hope I have, Father God. I just repent of all my sins, Lord. And I accept you as my Savior, Lord. I invite you into my heart. Please come into my heart, Lord. I give my life to you. Amen. If you just pray this prayer today for the first time with us, or recommit yourself to Christ today, Scripture says heaven rejoices when one walks in the family of God, or when one walks back in, and we rejoice along with you as well, because we've been praying for this very moment. We believe this is the most important decision that one can ever make with their life, or the one has already made with their life, by placing their faith in Jesus Christ alone, or accepting him for the first time. So if you just made this decision today for the first time with us, or recommitted life to Christ today, I encourage you to reach out to me or to one of our team members, because we want to be praying for you. We don't want to mock you at all. We don't want to press you. All we just want to do is be praying for you first and foremost, then give you the next steps and next resources to take. But before we give you the next steps, we want to be praying for you first and foremost, that God would be working in you as you continue along on this journey. The prayer is one of the most important things that we want to be praying for you first and foremost, and then give you next steps. Well, friends, do you mind if I bless you all today before I send you all on your way? Would you put your hands up to receive the blessing of Jesus? May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you. And may you never forget. May you never forget that God is God from everlasting to everlasting. Even if the earth does not exist, even if this world does not exist, God is still God, and that does not change. Amen? Amen. If you guys were encouraged by this topic, and you guys feel like someone else needs to be encouraged by this topic as well, would you guys please do me a favor? Click on that share button and share this hope with someone. Share this good news with someone. If you guys just need prayer for your life or hope, never hesitate to reach out to me or to one of our team members. We would love to be praying for you, love to just talk to you, answer any questions you have. And until next time, have a blessed day, and keep Christ number one. God bless you all. Much love.